That meantime, a sea of protesters in Lee County today speaking out against Florida's new immigration law. Governor DeSantis signed the bill in May, which he says has the toughest illegal immigration laws in the nation. WE News reporter Michael Hudak is live in Fort Myers. Michael, you are out in the streets today among those protesters. What do those protesters want us to know?
One of the women said out loud to me in Spanish, without the hands of Latino people, aquí, here in the state of Florida, you have nothing. And that is how people who are now lined up down US 41 are feeling right now. That's kind of their central gathering point down there. And I don't just mean a few people. I mean a lot of people, hundreds of people. And as you can see from the Wink News drone, they started just south of Page Field, made their way all the way down US 41 before ending up in front of the Lee County Commissioner's office, and all of them had the same message.
We're dreamers, we pay taxes, we just want to work, man. We're not criminals.
We make America great, people.
When the state's new immigration law takes effect 1 month from today, it will require companies with 25 or more workers to verify whether everyone is able to work in the U.S. legally. That's workers in the field, that's the service industry, and more. I have confirmed at least 6 local businesses closed today, most of them in solidarity with the Latino community and the protests. But some of them had no choice. They didn't have the workers to open today because the workers were over there marching. You will hear from those workers coming up on Wink News at 5 o'clock. For now, reporting in Fort Myers, Michael Hudak, Wink News.
And the day without immigrants protests are happening in every pocket of Florida. Let's go right down the road to Immokalee, where Wink News reporter Michelle Alvarez is live there. Michelle, what's the message out there today?
Yeah, there's pride, but also fear here. People documented and undocumented are proud of the contributions they've made to the community and the county, but they feel that the new Florida immigration law will force them to leave. People I spoke with today told me the only way to get the message out there is by uniting and protesting and having tough conversations. The Florida Immigrant Coalition, community leaders, and Unidos Immokalee will join together this afternoon for a peaceful protest in Immokalee. Many of them either skipped work or left early to participate. Earlier today, a couple dozen people stood at the corner of US 41 and Airport Pulling Road in Naples, waving flags and holding signs up that say immigrants make America great. I spoke with people who say they were out there to make their voices heard.
My family immigrated here from Colombia, and seeing their motivation and their determination and how hard they work every single day, it just makes me so proud to be a daughter of immigrants. And they definitely have implanted those morals into how I see my day-to-day life. And so, yeah, I'm just proud to call myself a daughter of immigrants for sure.
And protests are set to begin here at 4 o'clock in the parking lot of La Fiesta in Immokalee. For now, reporting live in Immokalee, Michelle Alvarez, Wink News.